Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Kiaradise. If you haven't already, please do subscribe, join the tribe, and follow me on Instagram and TikTok. TikTok now. I'm in Las Vegas staying at my lovely cousin's place. And I've been here, it's gonna be a week. Wow, it's gonna be a week tomorrow. So, I'm just gonna like quickly go through like my first week in Vegas and how that's been. This will be a vlog. Also, if you hear the air conditioner, that's because it's hot out here. Okay, it's triple digits, okay? Heat wave! Like, yeah, yes, yes, so I'm not turning it off. And if you hear it in the background, I'll put some music over it, okay? I'm gonna put some music in here. So hopefully it'll drown it out. I left Wednesday morning really early. I was trying to like get like done up, look cute. So it's my outfit. I was feeling it, even though like I really wanted to like show up like how I told you guys in my airport bonnet video, like Dita Von Teese, but I just, the outfit I chose just didn't work out. You know, your girl has like gained a little, needs to weigh. I took a Lyft. I was talking to my driver and he was telling me about where he's from in Mexico and where I should go. Cause I was trying to speak Spanish. Okay, here's the clip.
It was very interesting, very interesting. Comida es no como comida aquí, pero es más mejor. Sí. Porque la comida china en Estados Unidos no es como auténtico. No es auténtico.
So I was trying to speak Spanish. Y'all know how I am. I'm just gonna be like, hola, ¿cómo estás? No hablo español fluente, pero hablo un poquito suficiente para conversar. So he was telling me about where he's from, which is called Los Mochis. I've never heard of it, but yeah, that's just a new city. We can, you know, put that on our list. I'm trying to surprise my cousin, even though she knows I'm coming, but like I was supposed to Uber over or Lyft over to her job, and I just didn't want to be like, oh, I landed, I'm on my way. I just wanted to show up. So walking through the airport, another guy approaches me, or doesn't approach me, he like says to me, oh, a first time in Vegas. And I was like, and he's cute and it's all, he kind of like looked Indian, like South Asian descent. And he was like, oh, first time in Vegas. And I was like, yes. What about you? Oh, I come here all the time because of work. And then I was like, oh, what do you do? And he said he does like investment banking or something like that. And I was like, okay, well, do you have any like recommendations? Like, here's my thing. You see a pretty girl and you said something to me, why wouldn't you like ask me for my number or be like, yes, sis, I'll take you out. Maybe he's, yeah. The cute ones are, all the good ones are taken. We've talked about this multiple times. So maybe, but he didn't ask me, just kind of was like, the conversation just fizzled out, you know, he went his way. And I went my way. But the guy had recommended I take a taxi. So I did. And the taxi driver was really weird. Like really weird guy, older white male, like, was talking to me about he used to be a lawyer or he never passed the bar or something like that. Like he failed it twice and then lost all his momentum to do it again. I was like, oh, you know, with the bar, it's like third time's a charm. People fail the bar all the time. Like it's not that deep. Just like they make Kim Kardashian stuff seem like, oh, I'm such a failure. Oh my God. Like, girl, everyone is gonna fail. Most fail. It's okay to fail the bar. Like me, when I take the bar, I'm not even expecting to pass. I'm like, okay, sis, just get her done, okay? See how it is. Let's see how it is first round. And then he was telling me like, oh, just live your life, do what you want. I knew someone who like was a vegan and super healthy, super health conscious, got hit by a car and dead at 40. And then I know this 95-year-old lady, she drinks like just about a bottle every day and smokes like a chimney, and she's still kicking. She's outlived 5 doctors. And she's overweight and did it. And I was like, okay. You know, you get little anecdotes from people, that life lessons. You never know what the universe is is going to tell you. So the universe is telling me, girl, live your life, okay? You good. You good. Live your life. And pass the bar. Don't give up. Winter job. Cute job. Love it. Then I went to go to this awesome nail salon called Nab Nail Bar. And it's got, like, it's so me. It's such a vibe. It was a real vibe. And then they were playing, like, early 2000. Like, it was 2005 up in there. Because they played Shake It Off. Shake You Off by Mariah Carey. And I was like, yo, time machine. Take me back. Take me all the way back. And then the manicurist that I had, she was Vietnamese and didn't speak English very well. Too bad she doesn't speak Mandarin, because we could have been just like chopping it up. I showed her a picture of these leopard print nails. And I was like, I want that, but I want half, blah, blah, blah. And we're like, and she said to me, girl, you gonna need some red up here. And I was like, you right, sis, you gonna need some. She's like, what if I do this? I said, you know what? Just work, just do. How about, I'm like, I am your canvas, okay? Like, express yourself.
This is what I call my Cruella de Vil design, you know. It gives me, like, straight up, you know, from the movie.
Okay, so yeah, love my nails, had a great time, she's sweet. Okay, then we went to Korean barbecue with my cousin's first time having Korean barbecue. It was really good, but they had this, like, they called it soju, but it was in a, like, Capri Sun pouch, and I was like, honey, this is not real soju. So then the next day, Thursday, I didn't do anything, I just kind of chilled at home. And then Friday, I had this really cute outfit. We went to Fremont Street, and that was interesting. Like, they got all these, like, dominatrix ladies and guys there with those, it's not a whip, but it is a whip, but it's probably not called a whip. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Once I went to this dominatrix party, themed party in Shanghai, and my friend, like, hit me with one of those things on my butt, and I think, and I know for a fact, because I saw her do it, like, she did it ever so slightly, it was like, and I screamed at her so much, I could not imagine someone hitting me with that, like, oh my god, oh my gosh, like, so anyway, they have these, like, dominatrix people all around, and then one guy, I'll show the video. Like, he summons me, because we're waiting in line to give him those big, those long drinks that y'all see people in Vegas have. And he's like, you, and I'm like, there's a bunch of people around. Me? Yes, you. Me? Me. Yes, you, come here. I'm like, okay, so I go over there, and then he starts to, you know, like, spank or pick me up and stuff like that. I was like, well, don't hit me with that thing. You hit me with that thing, I swear to you, I am going to punch you in the face. Like, I promise, we're gonna fight right here. Just, no, don't. Like, so he's like, I won't. He just, like, you know, made it look like he was hitting me, but he didn't really touch me. But, and then, like, picked me up, right? And then he's like, okay, do you have a tip? And I'm like, okay, here's, you know, gave him $5. It was him and it was two guys. And then he was like, oh, and then a tip for my whatever. And I was like, took out another $5 and was like, here. What a way to make a living. Like, what a way to make a living. That is a hustle. And then Saturday, we took it easy as well. We ended up just going to Dave and Buster's because I really wanted to watch the basketball game. And yeah, that was fun with us. Like, together we have fun. But I'm like, where are squirrels at? Squirrels is my new way of saying men. Okay, eligible men, dateable men, Where are the squirrels at? Where? I'm looking cute. You should see my outfit. Like, look at that. Okay? Squirrels at. Something ain't right. Something ain't added up. Ain't adding up. Okay. So after we went to Dave and Buster's, we went to Area 15. So Area 15 is like, I don't even know how to describe it. It's like this place that has these like themed bars or something. So it's free to get in, but like you have to pay to get in each different room. When we got there, we went because, okay, basically Bree showed me a TikTok of a drink that was like smoke and mirrors and all this stuff. So that's what we wanted to do. Like, you know, because we're trying to experience, okay? Experience. We pay to go into like what's supposed to be like a grocery store, but it's kind of like a speakeasy because when we go behind all the stuff, there's like the secret room, blah, blah, blah. With all these, you know, had slides and everything like that, and I was not about to go down the slides. Like, I just,
so I would do one of these slides, but I'm not wearing any panties. Serious. Look at that. No, I can't do that. Look at that. No, I can't do that. Look at this.
So we end up finding the secret bar, which wasn't a secret. It was just around the corner. I'm like, y'all could have made this more like a speakeasy. It was just like, go over there. There's the bar. And we're thinking that's where we can get the drink. The drink that we're talking about, oh, we don't have it because we're waiting for the bartender. And then she comes up to us. I asked her, I said, okay, well, we're trying to experience. We want this drink. We want this. Oh, that's, we can't because we use this blah, blah, blah that we have to go from all the way to Arizona. I was, okay. So do you have anything that's like picturesque or like fun, different? You know what I mean? Experience. We're trying to experience. It's Juneteenth. Give us some experience. Okay. For the people, for the culture. So then, she's like, oh, this drink, which was called the Orange Dream, right? And it said it had like vanilla orange, whatever, with some whipped whatever. Girl, this was a Shirley Temple looking drink. Me and Brittany were so, we were over it. I was trying, you know, I'm usually like really lenient when it comes to restaurants, which I'm stopping. I'm not doing that anymore. I'm like, take it back. I don't want it. You know how some people do that? Like, I have an aunt who is like, nope, take it back. And I'm gonna start doing that instead of just swallowing it and eating it and or drinking it if I don't like it. Like, I'm gonna just start, you know, letting y'all know how I feel. When she came back over, because I took a couple sips of it and I tried, and me and Bree were just kind of like, we're just gonna drink it and go and be done and forget about the experience. We just gonna pay and go. And then when she comes back over and asks us how do you like the drink, you know, we both kind of automatically say, it's fine. And, you know, I'm continuing to drink it, and I'm just kind of like, look, I can't. I physically can't do it. So I called her over here. I said, look, we came here to get the smoke and the mirrors, the fire and ice, you know, like, that's the drink I wanted. This is a milkshake with orange juice in it. Like, no, this Juneteenth, what happened to Vegas, baby, Vegas? This is not giving what it's supposed to give. This is not it. I can't do it. Okay, I like hard, like bitter liquor spirits. Okay, I said to her, like, and Brie was like this. I said to her, I want hair on my chest after the drink. I don't want to be eating ice cream, an ice cream sundae. I don't know. And she was like, oh, okay, I see what you're saying, girl. I got you. She pulled out this like glass thing, and I don't know what it looked like. I've never seen that before. And then puts, you know, makes whatever, and then she puts a, like this little gun, this little smoke gun, and makes some smoke pop and whatever, and yeah, and we had that. That was it. And I mean, the drink itself wasn't good. It was juice. Like, juice. Make it strong, girl. I wanted spice. I wanted, you know, to hit the dangly thing in the back of my throat type of thing. That's what I wanted. But this is what you got to get. Okay, at least you got the little bubble, you know, that you pop and then the smoke comes out. Cool. All right. So that was, then we went home because I was like, girl, I'm tired of spending money on stuff that ain't worth it. I'm tired. Let's go back. We'd be more lit and having more fun just sitting in the house drinking. That's it. So anyway, yeah, that's what we did on Saturday. On Juneteenth. The next day, Sunday, we went to Wet n Wild Water Park. Now look, I've been to a bunch of water parks in my life. Haven't done it as an adult. Water parks are just not for me. This is like my first and last time going to Wet n Wild. We had so much fun, but my issue was there were pigeons everywhere. Everywhere. I was like so, but you, okay, you guys don't know, I have a phobia of pigeons. Like, full on phobia. Hate them. Just thinking about it, saying the word. We were in the lazy river, right? Luckily I have a sixth sense for these birds, but I'm also afraid of geese. A flock of geese were walking on the rocks, and I see them things, and good thing we were right by the entrance of it, because the water pushes you in a certain direction. You can't just, you know, and there's no way out of it unless you get back to the beginning of the circle. And so as we're approaching, I see the geese walking in a little huddle, not a huddle, a little single file line, like ducklings, you know? And ooh, I was like, cause we're asking like, should we do another lap? Yeah, let's do another lap. Let's go around one more time. And then I saw that, I said, oh, they're coming this way. And then they get in the damn pool. Oh my God. And they, you know, they started swimming and I was like, me and Bree, we was like, uh-uh, we out, I ain't getting in the sink, uh-uh. And then, what happened? I was trying to get to the exit thing, and I went past it a little bit, so I had to fight with my body to get off that. And me and Bree were talking about it later, and because they were just swimming past people. And I was like, good thing I got out of that pool. Because like, or I saw it before, because Bree was like, look, if you had seen, though, if they had swam past you, I know you would have had a fit. You would have gotten out of the water anyway, direction. There's only rocks. There's the entrance and then there's just a rock. Oh, you guys been to a water park. You know what I'm talking about. I would have had a heart attack. I don't even want to know what I would have done. But it would have been extra dramatic. And I probably would have to be committed, like for sure. It'd be like, no, this girl is a harm to herself and society and the geese. Water park. And then there's no squirrels. No squirrels at all. Squirrels meaning eligible men. All there is kids. Of course, or fathers. It was Father's Day. That's basically been Vegas. So far, we have a lot of plans, okay? We have a lot of things we want to do. Today is only Monday, so I'm not leaving until next Wednesday. So, I mean, like, I'm going to have another vlog, another video. And I hope you like this video. Give me some suggestions on things to do in Vegas, places to go. I want to vlog. I want to, like, do restaurant reviews, casino reviews, whatever. Let me know if you've been. If you haven't been, you know, let's just comment something, okay? So I hope you like this video. Love you guys. See you in the next one, okay? Bye.